The House of Democracy houses civil society organizations who are dedicated to see Namibia's democracy thrive. We spoke to some of them about how we fed.
As a born free and relating everything to the history that we always hear and, you know, we scrutinize, I think one can really say that Namibia has gone milestones. Look at, we have, for example, free education, and like it's better compared to the past where we have like apartheid. We have different how can I say curriculum where the minority have their separate curriculum compared to the majority blacks. So today we share the same curriculum, and I think that's it's a huge milestone.
Independence was something great for this country. Second of all, we've got a framework of from our legislation that is still based on Roman Dutch law, which is South African stuff. And we are the young minds who can change and revamp it. Why shouldn't we change and celebrate that? There's opportunity for growth for each and every Namibian. Eradicating the shacks is number one. Land for all people, number two. Three, all can be happy. Vision 2030.
Health-wise, we also have hospital were built, and you know, we have better schools, so economy has somehow grow, and I think it's better.
State where we are currently, most of our people would disagree, but in all honesty, I think we have grown in, and statistically it is shown that our GDP alone has tripled in between 1990 and 2015 alone. And obviously we can observe this in major sectors such as education. We have more institutions now. We also have growth in our main sector, which is mining. There's also some value addition, let's say, which grew into manufacturing.
Yeah, I think Namibia's got a lot to be proud of. The country is peaceful, and you know, we're a very stable country even compared to most of our neighbours. So it's great that that's continued for 29 years. I think there's been some recognition of that, like the fact that we are seen as having one of the freest media in the world.
You know, agricultural sector, we do more exports now, although we definitely need to improve, especially when it comes to self-dependency or reliance when it comes to the production of food.
So just like any project or policy that's introduced by government, it takes time to overcome, and because it's in the infant stage, so the next stage would be teenage, then maturity, so that we will only see the results afterwards. If it was good for what we leave behind, or is it bad for what we cause? Because there's an opposite effect to everything. For every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. And so far, some people have lost families for independence. And things have changed, but we would like to have better.
So yes, I definitely do think there is a greater change since independence, but we do need to work in, or rather in critical areas that sort of pull aspects such as inequality, such as high unemployment rate and unclear policies that hinder investment.
Our human rights and our governance records are pretty good according to quite a few rankings. So I think there's a lot of positive things that have happened. But I think unfortunately we haven't used those building blocks of peace and stability to build more progress, such as tackling poverty and inequality and creating jobs for young people. So we still have a lot to do. We could use our advantages, such as having a peaceful society, to create a lot more progress more quickly, I think, and that will be the major challenge in the future.